Let's all play What's My Line? And now, let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, a joker who's really wild, Soupy Sales.
Thank you, and thank you. It's a pleasure to welcome to our panel for the first time a lovely actress who just won and is still winning rave reviews for her performance as Blanche DuBois in A Streetcar Named Desire here on Broadway. Would you please welcome Lois Nettleton?
Critics are generally thought of as big bad wolves, but here's one who's a big bushy bear.
Yeah.
Gene Shalit.
He is.
I just got a bear kiss. What do you say about somebody about whom everything nice has already been said? You say two words, Arlene and Francis.
Well, speaking of critics, here's one man that gets raves from all of us, Larry Blyden.
Well, Lois, welcome. Gene.
Thank you, Larry.
Thank you.
I suppose you wonder why I've asked you here. Well, it is because we have our fabulous first challenger.
Oh, I
And would our first challenger enter and sign in, please? Deborah Settmeyer. Where are you from?
I'm from Paramus, New Jersey.
Okay, and somebody up there was groaning with delight when you came in, which is sort of nice. Panel, Deborah is president of a company that employs only girls. The company provides a service, and we'll show the audience what that service is. And we'll start the questioning with Gene Shalit.
You would, right?
Right.
Is this service, I hope to God, something I could use?
Yes, it is.
Terrific. You know me, huh? To perform this service, do you wear what you're wearing now?
No, I don't.
$1.09 to go, Arlene.
Is it a service that is very often associated with men?
Not necessarily.
Well, I think that we, most of us, would think of it as being associated with men.
Okay.
For the purposes of the game, it'll sort of...
Why, thank you, Larry.
Okay,
that's
Arlene.
That's rare. Is it a service that might have anything whatsoever to do with construction or maintenance?
No.
$2.08 to go. You know, I've been sitting here trying to think where I've met you before... And now I have it.
You've had her service.
Nope. In cabaret. Can you get a shot of her fingernails? They're green, like the girls in cabaret. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm sorry. Go ahead, Sue.
So are my teeth, but I didn't do cabaret. when you do this, Deborah, to do this service, could you come to my house to do it?
Yes.
Well, she, in a sense, could, Soupy, in that there is an aspect to the service which might involve her coming to your house, but in order to perform the service, this is another matter. So you have a qualified yes.
Yeah, but now I don't even know what I'm saying. Okay. Now, do you ever, so you could come to my house, right?
Right.
Would you ever handle anything in my home?
No.
No.
A 3, 9, and 7. She, are you kidding? She's too intelligent to go in. In that she is the president of a company, and there's a certain amount of office work connected with what she does. She is in the business world. And the service, I suppose, is a tangential service to the business world.
Well. Wow. Is that the way it works?
You give him a couple of days off, he comes up with those big words.
Do you
in any way come into contact physically with people? Do you in any way
touch them?
Touch them in line of your work.
She could, but it isn't essential to her service. So that's 4 down, 6 to go, Gene.
Is your service provided to a thing rather than to a person? In other words, do you serve an inanimate object rather than performing a service directly for a person?
No.
5 down and 5 to go, Arlene.
Oh. Do you have anything to do with helping those people in some way that they may not be able to handle themselves?
Yes.
They probably could ordinarily handle it themselves, Arlene, but in the special set of circumstances that she's in, they would not.
I see. I can rule out anything like the fact that you run a barber shop or anything like that.
Right.
Right. Well, Jean Shalit just gave me an idea. Do you run any kind of an answering service?
No.
6 down and 4
His idea was no good.
When you're doing this service, Deborah, would the importance of it come like at one time of the year more so than another time?
No.
7 down, 3 to go, Lois.
Does your service have anything to do... is it in the area of instructing of some kind or another?
No.
8 down and 2 to go, Gene.
Does your service make the person to whom you provide the service feel better or look better or happier?
Well, it would be such an indirect effect. That is 9 down and 1 to go, Arlene.
Do you have anything whatsoever to do with animals?
No.
No. So you fool them all. She runs a company which has limousines for hire.
Oh.
The company's name is Joy Day, and it's an all-girl limousine service in New York City. Where did you get the idea, and how did you get started?
Well, I'm also an actress. Yeah. And I had a friend of mine who was in the limousine business, a man. And we all know how times are in the business. Yeah. And I needed another source of income, and I kept asking him, please let me drive for you, let me drive for you. And he kept saying, no, you're a woman, and we need men. And so I ran into some money on a television show, a game show, and,
which I won. I hope you didn't hurt yourself in it.
No, and I just got the idea to invest it in the women limousine service.
Now, how many girls do you have working for you now?
I have two working for me right now.
And how many cars?
I have two cars.
Do they wear uniforms or what?
Yes, they wear uniforms, jumpsuits.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're uniformed.
Do you drive?
Yes.
Now, why is a girl driver better than a man driver?
Well, I think it's simply because the business is run by women, and they can give it a personal touch that only a woman can.
I'll certainly agree to that. Is anything funny happened to you in the process of...
Well, let's see.
Being a limousine driver that you can tell us about on television?
Well, I have a client who called one day, a woman, and she asked me to pick her up. She gave me the address. And I went to her apartment, and the doorman came out and brought the lady. She was very wealthy, and she had a little Pomeranian with her. And she let the dog go into the car, and she gave me the address. And told me to take the dog to a doctor. And I found out after about 3 or 4 weeks that it was a psychiatrist for dogs. And I thought it was a vet, you know.
Good Lord. Well, listen, good luck to you, and thank you for being with us on What's My Line.
We'll be back with more of What's My Line right after this message. We're back, and it's time for our next challenger to enter and sign in, please. Josie White. Hey, Josie. Where are you from?
Lake Havasu City, Arizona.
Okay, panel. Josie White recently won a championship which involves a product, and we will show the audience what kind of competition she won.
And let's begin with Soupy Sales.
Thank you, Larry. Josie, this thing that you won, is it any kind of a recreational sport?
Well, how do you mean?
A recreational sport to me would be a pool.
Pool?
Yeah.
That's hard to say, and it's not really in that category.
Oh, all right.
One down, nine to go, Lois.
Does this have anything to do, or is it more likely to be involved in the area where you live than...
Yes, it is.
Is it something that would be... have anything to do with a kind of area of country fair or rodeo or something that has more to do with country living than city living?
I think it would.
Yeah, there's an aspect of that, and there's a product involved with it, too, I'll tell you that much.
Is the product something that you created or in some way developed yourself, which you won the prize for?
No.
Two down, eight to go, Gene.
Larry, may I please recapitulate for a moment? Does our guest come from the state of Virginia?
Arizona.
Yeah. And Lake Havasu City, Arizona.
She won, in your opening statement, she won a contest.
She won a competition.
She won a competition involving a product.
There's a product connected with the contest.
And we have to find out what kind of contest it was?
Yes.
Is this product in any way edible or drinkable or consumable?
It is an edible product.
Okay. Is it common enough that it might be found in the kitchens of most homes in America?
Yes, it would.
Is it a product I could find in the supermarket?
Probably in some form.
Okay. Now, are we looking for this product in its original state rather than its manufactured and processed state?
You want to ask that another way?
Yes, I'm saying that if it could either be cotton or it could be a shirt made of cotton. And I'm saying, are we looking for the product before it was made into the shirt?
No.
Okay.
Three down, seven to go.
It's a cotton shirt. You know,
we're looking for a product, a finished product. Is that what you're saying?
Okay.
Okay. Is the product from an animal?
No.
Four down, six to go, Soupy.
But it is something to eat and it's found in the kitchen.
Right.
You eat rolling pins. No. Is it a food that would be eaten at dessert time?
Not usually.
In one form it could be, but it's usually not thought of as a dessert. Five down, five to go, Lois.
I don't know, this may be too big a jump, but by any chance, did you win a prize for consuming this product?
Thank goodness, no.
Six down and four to go, Gene. You got about 15 seconds. You have any notion at all what the product
might
be?
Well, I have to ask a preliminary question. Is this something that needs to be, if it's in my kitchen, before I eat it, do I heat it up in some way? Do I cook it or fry it or broil it or... something it?
Well, that's a big question.
No,
but
I mean,
yes, it's
rather than eating it right off the shelf.
Oh, sure. We could say yes.
Right.
I have to cook it first.
Yeah. I tell you, time is up. Do you have any idea at all?
Not churning butter or
no,
anything.
No, the product is pancakes.
Oh.
And the race she won was a pancake flipping race. She was crowned champion at the second annual pancake race in Lake Havasu, Arizona. It had something to do with the bridge, with London Bridge.
Right.
It?
The original course was rather unique in that you started at one end of the bridge, flipped in the center and to the other end. And it is comparable to about 3 football field lengths.
How old is that tradition of playing that?
It's about 500 years. It dates back 500 years originally in only England. And we like to get as much original English in keeping with the bridge, and so we kind of adopted it amongst darts and other things for our...
We have a problem here in the studio, Josie, in that we don't have a bridge. But we do have pancakes, and so, in the tradition of the short order cook, let's have our own pancake race.
Oh,
Jennifer,
please.
Could you zip those over for me? Excuse me. Thank you, Jennifer. Now, our producer, Gil Fates, has pointed out that usually when people have to flip a pancake, they'll do something rotten, like they'll take it and they'll consider that flipped. He, on the other hand, being a man who is something of a purist, wants to see it flipped. And so he has put this partition here, and you have to flip it over the partition and get it on the
plate. Catch it on the other side?
And catch it on the other side. Now, whoever, your accuracy counts, needless to say. Neatness isn't terribly important, but speed is. So, ladies, if you would come up, And Arlene, this is your pancake group over here. And Lois, these are your pancakes, and whoever wins will stand the winner of the gentleman's race. Are you ready, lady?
Oh, they're going to race, too?
They're also going to race.
No, I never
on your mark, get set, go.
Oh, do we have to pick him up?
No, that's all right.
Is that it? Can I pick him up again?
All right, sure. Yes. And Arlene has won on the ladies' side. Congratulations, my
dear.
Arlene, if you would just hang around for a minute. And gentlemen, if you would come up. Thank you, Jennifer, if you'd give us some new pancakes. Gentlemen, would you come up?
Okay, what do you want?
Soupfield, if you'll come over here. And may I have made a better contestant emerge victorious?
Can I do my impression of Al Jolson?
Okay, gentlemen. What do we do here?
I put them on your head.
I got aces back to back.
Thank you, gentlemen. Okay, gentlemen, you ready?
No.
Now we flip them over here.
Flip them over and catch them on the other side. Mark, get set, go.
Catch a falling pancake, put it in your pocket. Never ever let them go.
Hey, look at this.
Congratulations.
All of them?
Yeah, he got them all.
The time,
now, Gene, if you'll stay, and Arlene, if you would come up, please.
Oh, we're having a runoff.
Are you going to compete with him?
We're having a flip-off.
Here, I'll help. It looks like it's going to be a tight match, ladies and gentlemen. We have Arlene Francis over my left and Gene Shalit on the right. And
okay, you do a beautiful flip. Okay, are you ready, ladies and gentlemen?
You think I'm going to lose to Arlene, you're crazy.
We have a prize for whoever wins. On your mark, get set, go. There's one.
Seven.
Two. Three.
I cheated.
Woo! Four.
I'm going to get a job in a luncheonette.
Well, Arlene is finished, he's finished, and Arlene has won the pancake flipping contest. Joseph, come on up, baby. Would you say? Here we have our two champions, and could you bring us in a prize, please, gentlemen? Thank you, my dear. Number one, Flipper, it says there. And Josie, if you would present our champion with her reward. We'll be very
I don't think so, but I would like to hold it.
All right. Josie, thank you for being with us on What's My Line. Arlene, congratulations for being with us on What's My Line. We'll be back with more of What's My Line right after this message. You're beautiful. Time now for our mystery guest. Your blindfolds in place panel?
Yes, sir.
And would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? Okay, panel, you have 2 minutes. We'll go one question at a time. Fate's law prevails, and let's start with Arlene Francis.
Thank you. Mystery guest, are you best associated with the area of television?
Right, yes.
Soupy?
ma'am, is that because you're seen on a show of your own?
Right, yes.
Lois?
Is it a dramatic series?
No.
Gene?
Are you on early in the morning?
Well, yeah.
Arlene?
That means he's on some places early in the morning. Are you associated with a game show?
Yeah.
What?
Subi?
Yes?
Yeah.
Yes. An early morning game show.
Is that game show on NBC?
Oh, yes.
Lois? Lois?
Does the game show essentially use celebrities as the players as opposed to civilians?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Gene?
Is the program Hollywood Squares?
Yes.
Well, I guess we've all got it then. Arlene, you want to say it?
Peter Marshall.
Peter Marshall is who that is.
Hello, Arlene.
Hello. Gee.
I had dinner with Lois Nettleton the other evening. We were in Chicago. We played did a show together 2 years ago, only game in town.
Yeah.
And she said, I'm going to be on What's My Line Thursday. And I said, I'm going to be on it Friday. Yeah, so.
That was very
kidding. Yeah, nice to see you, my love. And Soupy and I, we just work together.
Yeah. Sure. I tell you, the two of us sitting here looks like uniforms for people who do this work. And it's sort of pick and pat of the game show.
Stump and Stumpy, here we are. Did Fun
you,
in one.
Did you bring the hats and the canes?
Of course, afterwards, yes.
Listen, how long has Hollywood Squares been on now?
8 years. We're in our eighth year, right.
And you're on at night, too?
Yeah, we're on twice a week.
That's really dynamite.
It
and
sure
what are you
is.
Doing in the East?
Well, I came back to talk about a book that I have... just had published.
I happen to have that book right
well,
here.
Well, I was hoping that you would. Yes,
and the name of that book is Cheer Up.
Cheer Up.
And I've just noticed something in it, Pete, which is really a hoot. He's got a thing in here, hate your name, cheer up. It's easy to change it. The change may do you good. Certainly didn't hurt. It says, think that your stockbroker is making a fortune while you're losing yours, cheer up. And then it gives you a cheery fact. But back to the name one. Does anybody here know who Tula Elise Finkley is?
Lois Nettleton.
Lois Nettleton, no.
No, it's Sid Charisse.
Yeah.
How about that? You want to
why
know?
Did
you
do
ever
this one right here.
It?
Oh, does anyone know who Arlene Carzangian is?
No, Lois Nettleton.
That's right. It's Arlene Francis.
Uh-huh.
Right.
We got you.
Does anyone know who Dino Crocetti is?
Oh, that's easy. That's right.
That's good. Right. How about Aaron Schwat?
Aaron Schwat.
That's Red Button.
That's Red
very
button.
Good, Soupy. X gets the square.
How about Emmanuel Goldenberg?
Manuel Goldenberg?
Right.
That was Edward G. Robinson.
Right. Gee, that's terrific.
Oh, what a good
all right,
game.
How about Arnold Raymond Cream?
Yeah. Oh,
Jersey Joe Walcott.
That's Jersey Joe, yes.
The book is Cheer Up, and Peter Marshall did it, and it's a beauty.
Thank you so much, Larry. My pleasure. Thank you very, very much.
Okay.
Thank you.
We'll be back with more of What's My Line right after this message. We're late. Goodbye.